for quarterbacks to step up and lead their offenses on the gridiron today. It's the Cardinals going up against the Buccaneers. With that, let's get out to Ray J, Raymond James Stadium, Brandon Godden, and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup lined up here between the Arizona Cardinals and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now the first carry for Doug Martin. And he's going to be stopped here on this first play as he gets it to the line of scrimmage and no more. On the tackle, Tyrann Mathieu. And one advantage for this offensive unit is the big target, Mike Evans.
Play to his strength, his size, and catch radius. Throw it up there, let him go get it.
Second down, Winston. They set up the screen to Martin. Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Doug Martin, 74 yards. And the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead. But he's used to running it that distance. Here he had to catch it too before making the run. Heck of a play for the score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who is a complete guy, who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
Play action. It's Palmer looking deep downfield. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Touchdown, Cardinals. Larry Fitzgerald, 85 yards. And the Cardinals are just an extra point away from tying this game.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. Now it's Adam Humphries on the return. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
The intended target, the tight end, Austin Seferian Jenkins. And that'll make it second and 10. And here is the Cardinal defense.
Tyrann Mathieu has a cornerback's build with safety skills. The Honey Badger knows where the football is.
Winston now. It's caught by Mike Evans. It's a gain of 9 yards. And that is going to set up a third and one.
That was a nicely run slant route. And what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield to a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
One man in the backfield, that's Martin. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Brandon Williams in there to bury him for a loss of 11.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
Second down, Martin. And nothing doing here as this time the run maybe gets him back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. And they only get a yard back there. They'll be left with a third down and long. And this defense looks for one more stop here on third after the run. Third and long for Winston. Try to lay one up deep. It got his man complete. That goes for a gain of 31.
Well, they just treated third and long as simply an opportunity to make an even bigger play. Normally, you're just trying to pick up the first down and you know where the sticks are. They took this thing way downfield. Confidence in the receivers to go up and make a play, even with defenders around them.
That goes for a gain of 31.
What really hurts defenses on screen passes is if they eat up one of their levels right away. Because you know most defenses three levels, D-line, linebacker, secondary. But on a screen pass, you're inviting the defensive line to get past them, and then you throw the ball over their heads, and now there's just two levels left to try and stop big guys out in front of a guy running with the football.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
This is why I've never been a big fan of trying to get too cute down here by the goal line. For every one time something like this works, it seems like it blows up about 10 times. And sure enough, they'll wind up losing yards here.
And the eighth play on this drive coming up. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. They come out with one back and three tight ends. His pass caught at the four. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Austin Seferian Jenkins from 3 yards out. And the Bucs are able to strike for six. The kicker, Roberto Aguayo, has it teed up and is about ready to get this one started. Now it's Ellington to return. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They felt their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they wanted to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
And this offense on your screen, one of the guys who knows how to win football games, Larry Fitzgerald.
Plenty of athleticism, but plays the game with incredible intelligence.
On second down, Palmer. Screen play, Johnson. No gain on the play, and it'll bring up a third down. Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis. It's the Cardinals in possession of the football. They're facing a tough spot, 3rd and 8 here to start things out. Set up the screen. That's complete. Fights off another.
I think the second tackler would have learned from the first.
And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
He's going to air one out. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Fans do love the long ball, don't they? And he already found his guy once. Tried to give him another chance there, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. Couldn't connect. But as you alluded to, he does have that touchdown from earlier, trying to keep him in the rhythm.
Here we go.
second and 10. It's Palmer again. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
And there was a good opportunity. Just went awry there. A drop pass. I guess that's why they call them running backs and not catching backs.
Get ready. Move. 95.
Again, it's Palmer. And that will be incomplete as well. The intended receiver was David Johnson. And it'll be fourth down.
But no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. So out come the Bucs now. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing.
The ball comes out.
Wow. That ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Winston gives to Martin on the draw. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
On third down, Winston. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good. But when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's winning football.
Oh, it's a wobbler here. Stays on his feet. Officially just 27 yards there on the punt. And the Cards will take over, first and 10. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Throwing is Palmer. He's going to float this one deep right side. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
And just know, when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. And the Bucs with an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. Palmer now looking for his tight end, fouls, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Levante David. And they take over. They'll set up shop at the 46-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Down. Here's the run with Martin. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Now that's the type of play that'll fire up the defense, hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
Again, it's Martin. And he'll be taken down after a short gain as that takes us to the 2 minute warning. 1:59 to go in the first half. We'll come back to Tampa after this timeout. Defense thinking pass. They've got the nickel set out on 3rd and 6. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Now Winston. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Normally he's pretty reliable. Usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
There, this one's high, but not very far. Only 29 yards on the punt there. Definitely not his best. And the Cards are going to have the football with a 1st and 10 deep in their own territory. The Cardinal offense now making their way back out onto the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Here's Palmer. And Gresham has it left side. Give him 3 on the play, and they're going to have a 3rd down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
So the run moves the chains, and here we go on 1st down. They go play action here on 1st down. He's going to let this one go deep. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at 2nd down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Screenplay, Johnson. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. So he loses 3 yards there. Now 3rd down. And they've got an extra defensive back out there now on 3rd and 13. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Brent Grimes. And it's a pick 6. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD.
Now that was a beautiful play, a pick 6. How would you punctuate something like that, partner?
You mean with an exclamation mark?
Exclamation mark, a big word. What would you do with that?
Ampersand?
I like it.
So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Fielded about a yard deep. Oh, nice move. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
Let's go.
Now a play fake here on 1st down. He's going to let this go deep, back over the middle. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, 2nd down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case,
and now this one's intercepted. A 3rd interception for Palmer. Picked off by Brad McDougal. And he returns it into enemy territory down to the 45-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And this is a spot late in the clock near midfield, though. Maybe take a couple chances, see if you get in field goal range.
You do that if you have trust. And this should be a position now where the great ones, they relish this opportunity to try to put points on the board.
It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that'll make it a 2nd down.
They completed the screen, but one of the things you worry about is can the quarterback get rid of the ball before he's actually tackled? So your offensive linemen have to hold up the rushers a little bit because you want to make sure you keep your guy's jersey clean throughout the game.
Jameis to throw it. He's going to rifle one deep left side. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And it'll be third down.
I know the initial focus was on how far that pass was downfield, but how about the coverage on the play? Able to stay with him, get his hands where the receiver's hands were going to try and catch the ball, tips it up in the air, and knocks it away.
And this is good. It was running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. So here's the Cardinals offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this is
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. They come out with one back and three tight ends. On second down, Johnson. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. At 5 yards on the play there, the drive will continue.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Carry here for Johnson, and not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. And this is Michael Floyd, complete. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Strength throwing the football downfield has never been an issue for this big guy. I still remember the first time I met him. He was playing for USC, and when I got introduced to him, I thought I was meeting their starting tight end, not their starting quarterback.
Such a presence, Carson Palmer.
Very much so. He's had it ever since he entered campus there and still has it today.
And they're going to speed things up here. The throw is Palmer. And oh, it's complete. What a catch at the 7. He got 29 yards that time. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best player out on the field. You still carry that supreme arrogance with you and continue to...
And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. Larry Fitzgerald, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Cardinals get a bit closer. And they will line up now for the two-point try.
We got 4. Let's go. Let's go.
Palmer looking to throw. And this one incomplete. So they went for the 2. They don't get it. Now Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Here comes the Buccaneers offense. They get their first reps of the second half. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see.
And that was a heck of a shot right there by Jameis Winston. Boy, he has a superior right arm, doesn't he? You saw him play baseball.
Yeah, he's actually a switch hitter in baseball. Outfielder, and then, of course, a very hard-throwing pitcher. That's translated well in the National Football League.
That it has. When he has to make that throw on a line, he's got plenty of arm to do it.
Winston now from the 50. Evans has it left side. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so.
When Mike Evans sees man coverage, I don't think he's the only guy who gets excited. I'll guarantee the guy throwing the ball does, because guess what? He's got a lot of options about where to place it because of Mike Evans' size and frame.
Winston now. And this is caught by Evans. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender, and that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
First down, Winston. Left side complete, Safarian Jenkins. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
I know I'm not in the rooting business, but I really like this kid, Austin Safarian Jenkins. Good catch there. I'm just hoping he can stay on the field and have some good health.
Now the Bucs hoping so too, limited to 16 games total his first two. And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucs. Mike Evans from 17 yards out. And the Buccaneers here finding a way to stretch their lead. Aguayo on for the PAT. And that'll make this a three-score game as the lead moves to 17. The kicker, Roberto Aguayo, has it teed up and is about ready to get this one started. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And an excellent return there as he's up to the 35, but make it the 40-yard line. So out now come the Cardinals. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Brad McDougal. And he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield stripe. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, why? Well,
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
They try to fire up the running game with Martin. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. He's fumbled already once, Charles. I'm not going to say that that was in his mind there, but I'm sure that during some of these plays, he is mindful of it.
And once you fumble the ball, you know what your team tells you and your coaching staff? Take care of it. Rest of the game. And it does get in your mind a little bit, and sometimes that slows down your effort in trying to get free from tackles.
And the defenders know it, too. They sniff that out, don't they?
Everybody wants to swarm the football. You know the rule is, first guy hold up the runner, everyone else try and get there and strip the ball free.
Back now in Tampa. It's the Bucs. They've got the football. They also are in front here on the scoreboard as we start the fourth. One man on the backfield. That's Martin. A first down throw for Winston. He finds his target. It's Evans. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. And defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. And look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side. Instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
It's a gain of 20 that time. And the Buccaneers are going to have a first and goal. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. He's played a great game. It continues right there, even with this lead. Confident to throw the pass and have the receiver. interception made.
There's no doubt who the leader of their team is there? There's no doubt who they want to ride all the way to the finish, because strategy would tell you run the football, run the clock down. Instead, they're letting him throw it because they feel that confident in what he's getting done.
And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucs.